What about your position, centre-half back? You've thrown yourself all over the ground, really, in the final series. Do you think the club might be better suited today for you just to play in a set position, even though you are the coach of the side?
Oh, I've had a few problems this year to find a bit of form, Shane, but it's only a matter of sort of trying to persevere and get myself together a bit. But I've just got to knuckle down and concentrate a bit more, I think, to do the job.
Thanks very much, Robert O'Connell, the captain, the coach of the Eaglehawk side, into his second grand final as the coach of the Borough senior team.
Right, Richard, in a moment we'll meet Brendan Mason from Northern United. Let's have a look now at some of the great highlights of the 1986 grand final.
Free kick.
There's Tricky's kick. It's an ordinary one. Only travelled 30 metres, and Exel has taken a beauty over the pack. He plays on, and he's rammed it through.
That to Jared Geary, and we'll have six or seven up before half-time.
Jared Geary goes for the long shot for goal. How does it look, ladies and gentlemen? It doesn't look too bad at all. It's there.
And at this stage.
Tricky, Evans and Marlowe combine to drive down to Geary.
A great influence, and of course, Jared Geary's having a big influence too. I think Robbie O'Connor might do well to go on to...
Southcombe's going to fly from the back, and a good mark to Eaglehawk. No, not paid. Ball feeds to the ground. Oh, and here's that man again. Tricky, goal. Goodness gracious me. Eaglehawk was in their pack. He couldn't win. It goes to Marlowe. He gets it across to Neiman. Neiman down the throat of Exel. Was beautiful football.
Here's Gavin Exel lining up for his third goal in Northern United sevens. He's not far out. There's no mistake about that one. It's through the centre.
It finds Evans at half forward. Evans feeds it on now toward De Barnes. And Barnes goes bang. Oh, goodness gracious me. This is an avalanche.
In the air goes Finlay. A handball out of the pack by Eaglehawk. Over to Wayne Walsh. Walsh has given it over to Murray Collins. Collins might have run two steps too far, but poked through off the ground. I think Darryl Gilmore has got Eaglehawk's first goal.
Here's danger. Marlowe for United. Half forward flank. Hand passes backwards to Exel. And on the run, this fellow would nearly kick this on a good day. It's curving back. Oh, goodness gracious me. A ripper.
And it's Brett Sheldon, one of the Northern United's key players. Towards centre-half forward. They fly in here. Good mark, Peter Rogerson. Elects to play on. Eaglehawk needs plenty of this sort of running play. Two bounces, Peter Rogerson. Goes through the centre of the QEO. Looking up here for Gilmore. Gilmore's in front of Neiman on this occasion.
Marlowe takes it for United. He drives down looking for a running Exel again. He's shoved away. McDougall. Bang! It's home! Oh, brilliant football, Exel.
We dominated.
69-9. Well, 10 goals in front, and what's happened here? Barnes has chipped it after the kick out, and he's kicked one. Lee Slater for the first time all day, bursts out of the centre. He'll be looking for Crone or Gilmore. Crone! That's a great mark, a one-hander. To open territory, Barnes. Oh, don't tell me he snapped that right through the centre. Oh, a beauty! And full forward, punched away by McDougall. Won beautifully by Barnes, and he's kicked another one. And there's going to be a downfield free kick to Darren Tricky, who races away from Pierce, gives it to Langan. Go bang, Langan. He has, and it's home again.
It's going to land in the goal square. Exel's up, and Exel's got it.
Gavin Exel will kick his sixth goal, could have kicked 10.
And long way out, Dennis, but Alan Besley mentioned that breeze was blowing down to that far end. Let's see how he goes. That's a glorious kick, Exel. I think that might have been touched behind the line. Goal. Beautiful goal, Exel. Looking for Sheldon was a poor one, and it goes to Crone. And there's the siren there. That's the siren, and there goes the champagne. Did they ever get the cork out? I don't think they did. But United the Premiers, three in a row.
Well, can they make it four in a row in the Bendigo Football League in the 1987 Grand Final? Let's take you across now to Richard Jones.
Thanks, Alan. Well, we have Brendan Mason in the studio, and Brendan, of course, has coached Northern United into their fourth successive grand final. Brendan in his first year as senior coach of the Swallows. Brendan, it must have been a great thrill for you to win that second semi-final in an important match like that. Do you envisage any great changes to the side for today's game?
No, we're not making any big changes at all, Richard. We're approaching the game very much in the same manner.
Anyone doubtful, Brendan, that you may have to swing a couple of late people into the team, perhaps, from the side named on Thursday night?
No, as it is, Richard, and we've got full confidence in the 20 that we're taking in.
Neville, a question for Brendan?
Yes, firstly, Brendan, congratulations on a very fine year. I guess coming in and coaching a team that has won three premierships in succession, there's a lot to lose, and congratulations on making the grand final. Brendan Mason himself, playing position that you believe that Brendan Mason will be playing today?
Oh, I'd like to be an on-ball player today. That's where I've played most of my football and most of my career, but due to a couple of operations this year, my fitness isn't as I'd like it to be, so unfortunately the more match fitter conditioned players that will have to shoulder the responsibility in that department today.
Right, the side that was named in the paper, actually I picked Brendan Mason as a half-back flanker, so that probably won't be the case today. The other position of concern, looking at your team, was perhaps Darren Davies as a rover, perhaps should be in the 18.
Yes, we've thought about that, and Darren hasn't had a lot of senior football under his belt at this stage. He's been a definite acquisition to the club, and we just thought he may have been a little bit overawed prior to the second semi-final, and we decided to go in with more experienced players in that area and leave Darren one of the players we selected to from the interchange.
Shane, have you got a question for Brendan? There's a side up on the screen.
Yes, a couple of questions for Brendan. Richard, Brendan, have you played in a winning grand final side yourself?
Not at club level, Shane.
And I know you were involved with some good sides in Ballarat, weren't able to quite make it, so obviously the nerves will be going your way today because you've been nearly there in the past. This would be, would I be able to say, the best side you've played with?
Yes, it'd be equal to any. There's no doubt about that I've played with, and I was probably more confident going to any final than I have been in relation to the personnel that we've got into the side, hopefully that can carry on and do the job.
Well, talking of that personnel, a number of new players into the club, Couchman from Ballarat, Miles, Muir, VFL experience, young Scott Langan, who won the Rookie of the Year award, yourself, of course, Brooks, Keeley, some great names there. Was it a tough job to try and mould those guys together, all new at a club in 1 year?
Well, there are great names there now, Shane. You might say they're great names now. Really, when they came to the Northern United Football Club, they were unknown quantities to everybody. Mm. And as a result of their performances this year, they've fitted very smoothly into the side. And they've come up each week and done the job. And I know myself and the match committee, the coach and the administrators are very happy that we've been probably lucky and fortunate in the selection and the quality of the recruits that we have picked up.
Would you thank Brendan Mason, coach of the Northern United Football Club, for his appearance this morning?
Well, we've heard from the panel and we've heard from the coaches, and coming up on the other side of the break, some of the personalities of the Football League here and their tips for today's great game.
When the job in the garden needs a digger, a slasher, a trimmer or a trailer, hire from Eaglehawk Hire Service. If the job needs spraying, scaffolding, concrete, power, cleaning, shifting or lifting, hire from Eaglehawk Hire Service. There's tools for cutting down, cutting up and carting wood. And Eaglehawk Hire have workshop tools, welders, trenches and laser levels. Yes, specialist hire service from Eaglehawk Hire Service. Open 7 days a week at the rear of Nyanga Park Service Station, Peg Leg Road, Eaglehawk.
Are you in a business where cleaning time is costing you money? Then you should have a look at the range of products from Elmore Chemicals. Their disinfectants are widely used in industry, garages, engineering, in fact, most industries. They also have brooms and brushes, mops, buckets and chucks, wipers, almost everything associated with cleaning. Next time you're ordering your cleaning supplies, give Elmore Chemicals a call. They're proud of their product and prices. Elmore Chemicals, they have a solution for your cleaning problem.
You know there's a new arrival at the Bendigo Motor Company. It's the budget-priced Mazda 121. And I'm not talking about a facelift. This is a brand new motor car featuring the very latest Mazda technology, exceptional economy, easy access, and a unique fun top. Test drive the Mazda 121 now at the Bendigo Motor Company. And while you're there, why don't you check out their new four-wheel drive? It's a ripper.
Absolutely everything has been reduced at the Captain's News Warehouse Sale. With every bed sold, you get a free set of sheets or a free woolen underblanket. Bah! On now, but only till Saturday, so hurry in before everything goes. Oi, you, come back here.
Welcome back to our grand final telecast and the big game coming up at 2 o'clock this afternoon between Eaglehawk and Northern United. Let's have a look now at some of the selections of some of the district personalities in football.
If you want me, come and get me. You don't have a chance if you don't move now. I'm not waiting any longer. You know that I'm playing to win this time.
MO player that is the captain of, well, ex-Midi MO player, the current captain of Northern United. And they did win the second semi-final, and I think it will be four in a row if they kept this one on.
An interesting year. Northern United have been in front for most of the year, but when you come to a grand final, that's a one-out game. Eaglehawk have got the advantage of being able to throw everything at Northern United, and I think that if the game's closed halfway through the third quarter, they could cause an upset on Sunday, and I think they might just get up.
Well, I guess now in the last two times that Eaglehawk and Northern United have met, I've gone for Eaglehawk. I think I put the moz on them both times, so perhaps to give them a chance this year, I'll go for Northern United. I think they've got the better all-round strength. I think they're the best side in the league. They've proved it all year, and I just can't go past them for this year's grand final.
Yeah, look all right, Northern United. I saw Eaglehawk play Kyneton the other week, and I don't know, the hot tip is Northern United, so I've got a few mates out the borough, so hope they do well. If you want
me, come and get me. Don't have a chance if you... I don't think you can go past Northern United, Alan. I think they're a very, very even team. I don't think they rely on any one player to win the game from. They're a very strong overall side, and I just think that they'll have too many guns for Eaglehawk, but it should be a good game.
Well, I think you have to go for the favourites, Alan. I think Northern United, just their all-round strength is just going to be too strong, although I think that probably Eaglehawk have come through the hard way, and I think that it's been a good build-up to the final series. So anything can happen in a final series, we know that in football, and so I suppose what we're hoping for is a good close game, but I think Northern United just get home.
I think Northern United should win it. I think they should win it easy. They've got a better running side, I think.
I'll go for Northern United because I think psychologically they've got it over Eaglehawk at the moment, but just the same, grand finals on the day are won by the side that takes advantage of the situations that arise. And I think that it's going to be a very tight game, much tighter than people expect, because I think that Eaglehawk can rebound and Northern United are there and maybe become a little bit complacent.
Well, there's some of the tips of the district personalities and some VFL footballers on today's BFL Grand Final. Now to wrap up proceedings on the selections for this afternoon's big game, once again, here's Richard Jones.
Thank you, Alan. Well, it was impressive to see a former Eaglehawk star in Basil Ashman going for Eaglehawk. We'll now look at another Eaglehawk, former Eaglehawk coach's predictions. Dennis.
Thanks, Richard. I think obviously Northern United, extremely powerful side. And I went through some of the younger players before, but I think today also the older players on show, some of them, it's remarkable how many players in the guide are 31. Have you ever noticed that? 31s and 29s.
Fair few of those, yes.
Evo and Gary Evans and Tony Southcombe, Gary Mountjoy and David Wharton have been magnificent footballers in this league, and I think that's a couple of those at least people may be seeing for the very last time in this league, and I think they'll give a good account of themselves. They're proven players. I think on the other side of the ledger, Eaglehawks players, some of whom didn't own up last year, but Rogerson and Darby Munro, Robert O'Connell, Wayne Walsh, Mark Mackinder, the 30-plus brigade. I think that really it comes down to that group of players, some of the middle-aged players, football age, 25s to 26s. And I repeat that I think that if players like O'Connell and Collins and Finlay and Walsh and Rogerson and Crone and Gilmore have got good enough memories of 12 months ago, that I think that despite the fact that Northern United obviously have a better manpower, I'm going to back with my heart and not my head. I'll go for Eaglehawk.
Well, we've got Basil Ashman and Bill Bonney and Dennis Higgins going for Eaglehawk. Now we'll look at Shane Healy, who admits only to being 29. He'll give his selection.
Well, it's better than being 238, as one area said Brendan Mason may have been in the last couple of days. But two things I thought were worth bringing up. Two games in a month is a concern for me with Northern United. Could be a pretty warm day, and I just wonder whether that might just have a little bit of a story to tell in the final stages of the game, if, as somebody said earlier, it's tight in that third and fourth quarters. As I said at the beginning of the hour, Richard, if Eaglehawk can physically harass United in that first half, put them off their game, and not let them get away to the start they got away last year too, and I think they kicked the first seven goals of the match, then the Borough would have to be in with some sort of a chance. And if they can get on top across the centre, Shannon, Collins and Evely have a huge task to hold Lang and Mountjoy and also young Keeley. If they can and maybe get the edge across there, then they're going to have the chances to win the game. I think as Ron Best said in the highlights a moment ago, if they can take advantage of the situations that arise and make the play, they have got to be in with a chance. I hope it's not one-sided. I think the Swallows will win, but I'm prepared to say it could be closer too than a lot of people feel.
Neville, what's your viewpoint?
Well, I'm confused, Richard, after Dennis's summing up. It was the best square-off I've ever heard in the finish. After bagging the oldies from Eaglehawk, he's turned around and tipped Eaglehawk. But I do believe that what he, the comments that he made in relation to the middle-aged guys in relation to football age, who've been around for a little while, haven't played well against Northern United in the previous two encounters. Those players need to play well, but I think that Northern United just have the overall strength, depth and retain possession of the football too well.
It's a bold prediction, though.
Thanks very much, Neville. Well, I'm going for Northern United, even though there's some talk today that David Wharton might not be 100% fit. I still think Northern United have the manpower to win it. They've certainly got the forwards. I'm going for Northern United. So it's 3-1 on this panel for the Northern United side to take out the 87 grand final.
Would you thank our panel? Richard Jones, the chairman of the panel, Dennis Higgins, Robbie O'Connell, Neville Strauch, Brendan Mason and Shane Healy. That concludes our preview of this afternoon's grand final, and after this break we'll take you out live to the Queen Elizabeth Oval for the 1987 Comet BFL grand final.
This has been another TV8 sporting presentation. Grand Prix racing is reaching fever pitch. Piquet, Senna and Mansell are leading the charge, with the Williams and Lotus teams frantic for victory. Join us in Portugal tonight at 10:30 for Grand Prix action, live on TV8 Sport.
It's a beaut and sunburnt country, where Sheilas are real honeys and sweet. But it's water sport that the ace fires up, the pump that can't be beat. Blow it a kiss and it'll start. The Onga runs it through. It'll clean your pool and run your spa and never make a blue. Just ask the bloke that knows them. There's one just right for you.
For the complete range of Onga Stay Right products, see Milne's Irrigation, High Street, Bendigo.
He's young, successful and good looking. Yet only 6 months ago, he was going bald. It was then that he signed up for Advanced Hair Studio's revolutionary strand by strand hair replacement program. Strand by strand is the most modern and painless way to solve the problem of lost or thinning hair. Advanced Hair Studios replaced his hair the way he lost it, strand by strand. It left Mark with a full head of hair and tons of confidence. Advanced Hair Studios Strand by Strand. For free information, phone now.
For the widest range of outdoor power equipment, Santons is the only name you'll ever need. They have mowers, chainsaws, brush cutters, lawn tractors, outboards, boats and much more. But most importantly, Santons have a reputation for excellence in service and spare parts. And they've served the people of Bendigo for over 40 years. So for top deals and great backup service, see Bendigo's outdoor power equipment experts, Santons, King Street, Bendigo.
For real know-how on outdoor power, see Bully and Brett at Santons.
That was a close shave.
It's that one day in September, and many have put the boots away. Today, a grand final showdown to remember. Will Northern United continue their winning way, or can Eaglehawk produce the upset of the season? TV8 Sport now takes you live to Bendigo's Queen Elizabeth Oval for the 1987 Grand Final.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, from the Queen Elizabeth Oval in Bendigo. For Grand Final Day 1987, we're about to see the Northern United Swallow burst through the banner. Onto the field, the hot favourites for this year's game, and there's been a couple of very important late changes in the Northern United side. We'll mention those to you in just a moment. And now I'd like to introduce my co-commentators here on TV8 on this grand final day in Bendigo. And firstly, good afternoon, Richard Jones.
Good afternoon, Shane, and good afternoon, listeners and viewers. It's a great afternoon here at the QEO. Northern United have just gone through the banner. It read maroon and gold, gold and maroon. If you can beat us, you can swallow our throne. There's the team up on the screen. And of course, with a late withdrawal of David Wharton, Shane. David Wharton, the number one ruckman for United, is out with strained medial ligaments. David Ludeman will be taking the tap at the first bounce. And Tony Southcombe, obviously from the forward pocket, will have to do some work in the ruck when the ball's in the forward line, but probably also a little bit around the ground as well.
And good afternoon, Dennis Higgins.
Good afternoon, Shane. Good afternoon to all the viewers. Quite a good day here at the QEO. Not quite as sunny as we thought it might be, but Eaglehawk boys are really revved up. Disappointing for David Wharton. He's done a medial ligament in the knee. Probably have to have an operation before he plays again, so he'll be disappointed. But young Darren Davies has been given a chance to go into the senior 20.
We've just had a look there at the Eaglehawk side. They're coming onto the ground now. The Mighty Hawks, the Quiet Achievers, is what the banner says. And Robert Ninger O'Connell leads them onto the QEO. They've been here three times in the last 4 years. And on those four occasions, well, we've seen United, maybe if they can win today, make it four flags. As far as the borough goes, two of those last three times have been defeats to the Mighty Swallows, and today they'd love to make it a victory. Dennis, let's have a look at the side. No real changes there.
No, the Eaglehawk side probably won't line up exactly like that, actually. I don't think Robert O'Connell will play at centre-half back. I think Tracy Wilson or somebody like that will probably be given the job on Jared Gere. I'm hoping that Robert O'Connell plays up the field, perhaps ruck roving or something, and leads from the front. But the Eaglehawk side's settled. They've got the job in front of them, but they're pretty revved up, Shane.
Yes, and certainly Ninger had the disappointment last year of seeing the Borough boys just steamrolled in that opening quarter. And we enjoyed the grand final breakfast very much today. And, of course, since then, the change in the Northern United side has just got a few people talking here at the ground. There's a shot of Brendan Mason, of course, the captain coach of the United side. He's going to be a key. And, of course, so is O'Connell, his opposite number on the Borough side. With Wharton out, what changes do you see maybe coming over the game?
Well, Wharton certainly, I believe that Wharton's one of the players that Eaglehawk players have got long memories of. Every time they seem to get beaten, he's one of the leading lights. But don't forget, he didn't play last year, and Eaglehawk didn't cope too well. But certainly that physical strength and that ability to make players look over their shoulder that David Wharton's had for 8 or 10 years, I think that that'll probably be the main effect. But I think the Eaglehawk boys, regardless of who's playing and where they line up, it's got to own up to one player and try to beat one player each. If they can do that and they can be really aggressive at the start, it should be really interesting.
In the earlier games, in the under-18s, Eaglehawk 13-14-92 defeated North Bendigo 6-7-43. And in the reserve grade, a premiership to Golden Square, 14-8-92, defeating Sandhurst 11-6-72. Richard, a shot there of Tony Southcombe. What an important part he's going to play in this game. What a great player he's been for many years for the United and many other football clubs in Central Victoria.
He certainly has, Shane. There's Tony Southcombe. He led Northern United to their previous three premierships in 84 against Eaglehawk, 85 against Sandhurst, and, of course, last year, with Gavin Exel kicking 7 goals and Tony Barnes 6 against the Borough Eaglehawk boys.
We've got the Threlfalls, Ron and Rod, in charge here this afternoon as the umpires. For those who don't know the Queen Elizabeth Oval, it's a very, very big ground with deep pockets, and you do need to have a winning centre line on this ground, and that really is going to play a telling part to see which side gets the ball out of the centre and which side gets on top on those two wings. We'll be describing the ends as the Northern or Barnard Street or Scoreboard End and the Southern or City End for those who don't know the ground. We should congratulate all the Premiership sides in the area over the weekend. Donald, surprise winners yesterday in the North Central Football League. Stall, surprise winners in the Wimmera League. And it's been a real year of surprises. We even almost saw a great surprise in Melbourne yesterday with the Demons going so close to maybe causing that boil over and moving through to the grand final.
Yes, and yesterday afternoon, Shane, out at Tulane, Stanhope was too strong for White Hills. There wasn't an upset out in that league. Stanhope never looked in danger for my money. I was out there, good crowd, over a $6,000 gate at Tulane yesterday. Stanhope with too many good forwards, Graham Waite, Clark, and Nexup kicking goals, too good for White Hills boys. Ian Toole, 3CV station manager, kicked 6 goals, 1 out of 13 goals for White Hills, a good performance.
Let's now join Alan Bisley for the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 1987 Bendigo Football League Grand Final. This year featuring Northern United, out to make it 4 in a row. The challenge comes from the Eaglehawk Football Club. Would you please stand now for the national anthem? Now, ladies and gentlemen, we call on the two captains, Ian Marlow from Northern United, Robbie O'Connell for Eaglehawk, and the chairman of the board, Bill Bonney, will toss the coin.
Your defenders, Ian. Decent call.
Heads it is. Ian Marlow's won the toss and will kick to the Barnard Street end of the ground.
Thank you, Alan Bisley and Dennis Higgins. You took the Borough to a premiership in the early part of this decade. How do players feel at this stage, especially the youngsters who mightn't have been there too often before?
Well, Shane, obviously they're pretty tight, but I was just watching just a sidetrack on the one that Northern United won the toss. The breeze is actually across the ground, and I don't think it'll have a great effect, but even if it has a slight advantage to the Barnard Street end, I think that might be a good thing for Eaglehawk, because I think that they've mainly got to concentrate on being very aggressive in the first quarter anyway, particularly. But Eaglehawk, Northern United guys,